ಆತ್ಮೇತಿ ಮೂರ್ತಿ ಭೇದ ವಿಭಾಗಿನೇ ವ್ಯೋಮವತ್ ವ್ಯಾಪ್ತ ದೇಹಾಯ ದಕ್ಷಿಣಾಮೂರ್ತಯೇ ನಮಃ. ಓಂ ಸಹನಾಭವತು ಸಹನೌಘ್ನಕ್ತು ಸಹ ವೀರ್ಯಂ ಕರವಾವಹೈ ತೇಜಸ್ವಿನಾವಧೀತಮಸ್ತು ಮಾ ವಿದ್ವಿಷಾವಹೈ. ಓಂ ಶಾಂತಿ ಶಾಂತಿ ಶಾಂತಿಃ. ಚಿದ್ರಗಣೇಶಾಯ ನಮೋ. ಮಹ್ಯಂ ಸುಖಂ ನಿತ್ಯಂ ಸ್ವಪ್ರಕಾಶಂ ವ್ಯಾಪಕಂ ನಾಮ ರೂಪಯೋಃ ಅಧಿಷ್ಠಾನಂ ಬುದ್ಧಿಬೋಧ್ಯಂ ಬುದ್ಧೇರಿತ್ಯಂ ಅಪಾರಂ ಸರ್ವವೇದಾಂತವೇದ್ಯಂ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಕ್ಪರಂ ತದೇವ ನಮಸ್ತೋನ್ಯ ಇತಿ ಮೇ ನಿಶ್ಚಿತಾಮತಿಃ. ಯೆಸ್ಟರ್ಡೆ ವಿ ಲುಕ್ಡ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಮನನ ಲಕ್ಷಣ. ಮನನ ನಾಮ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಕ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಐಕ್ಯ ಸಾಧಕ ತದ್ ಭೇದ ಬಾಧಕ ಯುಕ್ತಿಭಿಃ. युक्ति भी सदा अद्वितीय ब्रह्मात्मय के अनुसंधान. एंड इन दैट देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ युक्तिस. वन आर प्रत्येक ब्रह्मैक्य साधक. दोज युक्तिस दैट विल लैंड यू इन ऐक्य बिटवीन व्यष्टि एंड समष्टि. एंड दी अदर इज भेद तद भेद बाधक. मीनिंग प्रत्येक ब्रह्म भेद बाधक. दोज वुड यू निगेट दी differences between the Vyashti and Samashti. You have seen the former, let's look at the latter now. Bheda Badaka, Badaka Yuktayaha. Anumana Pramanam, there also Anumana Yukti is taken. Pratyak Parachitor Bhedaha Mithya. The difference, there is a difference between Vyashti and Samashti, Pratyek Atma and Parabrahma. Both are consciousness. But on top of the consciousness, Satchidananda or Satyam Jnanam Anantam, which is their Swarupa, we can't even say there, because there are no two entities anymore when you land on the Satchidananda Tattva, which cannot be segmented. But there is a Bheda. What is the Bheda? The Upadhi Bheda is there. At the Samashti level, the Maya Upadhi creates Ishvara, whereas the Avidya Upadhi at the Vyashti level creates Jiva. That Bheda is there. That Bheda is Mithya. Upadhi Adhinatvat, Upadhyadhinatvat, Ghatad, घटाकाश मठाकाशयोः भेदवत. जस्ट लाइक घटाकाश एंड मठाकाश आर जस्ट नेम्स गिवन टू द सेम आकाश विच वॉज नेवर सेगमेंटेड ड्यू टू द घट उपाधि एंड मठ उपाधि. यन्नेवं तन्नेवं यद उपाधिकं न भवति तन्मिथ्या न भवति. सो दैट विच इज नॉट इन दिस टाइप ऑफ दिस टाइप इट कैन नॉट फॉल इनटू दैट कैटेगरी. Thereby, the chit itself is not an upadhi. Yanna evam upadhikam yat chit na upadhikam bhavati, upadhikam na bhavati, tat chit mithyana bhavati. You should say sa actually, chit is trilinga. So, ya chit upadhikam na bhavati, sa chit mithyana bhavati. यथा व्यवहारिक घटपटादि भेदः औपाधिकत्वाभावाद् एव सत्यः न मिथ्या तद्वत्. व्यवहारिक घटपटादि भेदः औपाधिकत्व अभावा. इन व्यवहार यू कैन नॉट से दैट दी घट एंड पट आर उपाधीज. इन व्यवहार यू हैव टू डील विद दी घट. यू आर नॉट डीलिंग विद दी चैतन्य देयर. यू आर डीलिंग विद दी घट एंड पट. देयर दे आर नॉट उपाधीज. When you are dealing with Chaitanya, then they are upadhis. Tadvat. Ata eva yatra upadhi nibandhanaha bhedaha tatra tatra mithya eva saha. Thereby we have a vyakti now. Yatra yatra upadhi nibandhanaha bhedaha. Bheda is what? Upadhi Nibandana. Nibandana is created by that. So, Upadhi Nibandana, Nibandana means Karana. So, Upadhi Nibandanam Yasya Bhedasya Sahabhedaha Upadhi Nibandana. Upadhi Karanam Yasya. Upadhi is the Karana for which Bheda. Meaning, Bheda is created by the Upadhi. Otherwise, there is no Bheda. Tatra Tatra Mithyaiva Sa. Saka Bhedaha. Sabheda mitya bhavati natu satyah. So the bheda created between parambrahma and pratyagatma is upadika due to jiva sharira and the jiva sharira avidya avidya karya and maya sharira which is mitya. So that is the anumana pramana for bheda badaka between pratyak and parabrahma. Upamana, example is given, yatha bimba pratibimbayor bhedaha mithya tatha jiva brahmanorapi. So just like example is given, between the bimba and pratibimba, between the original and the reflection, is there a difference? There is no difference. Otherwise, if there is a difference, we won't look into the mirror to see whether there is something in the eye. We cannot see the eye. The eye cannot see the eye, therefore we have to look in the mirror. Now when you are looking in the mirror, the eye that you see in the mirror is not different from the eye that you have. If there were a difference, we wouldn't look at it. So yatha pratibimba, bimba pratibimbayo bheda mithya. The difference is mithya, there appears to be a difference, but there is no difference. Tatha jiva brahmanorapi, jiva is like a reflected consciousness, brahma being the original. The bimba chaitanya is not different from the pratibimba chaitanya is not different from the brahma chaitanya, which is the bimba chaitanya. Arthapatti pramana. Arthapatti is used. So presumption. Mahavakyer Upanishadsu jiva brahmanor abheda eva nishchitaha. This we have seen earlier also. We have seen in the sadhaka yukti. Same is used for Badaka also. You just reverse it. Mahavakyer Upanishadsu Jiva Brahmanor Abheda Eva Nishchita. We know that Tattvamasi has been taught 9 times in Chandogya Shashtodhyaya. Everywhere else, only Aikya has been taught. Tatparya Nishchaya is there. We have seen the Shadlinga yesterday. Yadi Pratiyamanopi Bhedaha Vastutaha Na Mithya Syat Tarhi Mahavakyer Abhedona Pratipadyeta. Pratipadyatetu. So Anyatha Anubhapatti Pramana is used here for Arthapatti to show that otherwise not possible. Had there, Yadi Pratiyamana Api Bheda. There is a Pratiti. Bheda Pratiti is there. There is an appearance of Bheda. If that appearance of Bheda, difference between Brahma and Jiva, had been real, Vastuta Na Mithyasya, had it not been mithya, earlier it was said, had it been real. Here it is said, had it not been mithya, the difference. Had the difference not been mithya, then tarhi mahavakye abhedon na pratipadyet. Then the aikya wouldn't have been taught between the parabrahma and pratyagatma. Where is it taught? Through all Mahavakyas, in all Upanishads. Pratipadyatetu. So it has been revealed. Tasmad arthapatti pramanadapi jiva brahmano bhedaha mithya eva. Therefore, anyatha anubhapatya, otherwise it is not possible, since Shruti is revealing aikya, which Shruti wouldn't have done had there been real Bheda, meaning had the, here we should say, had the Bheda between Parabrahma and Pratyagatma not been Mithya, then Abheda wouldn't have been taught. Aikya has been taught, therefore the Bheda between the two is Mithya. Anupalabdhi Pramanamapi. Anupalabdhi, absence. Jagrat Swapnayor Upadehe Sattvat Jiva Brahmanor Bheda Pratiyate. In waking state and in dream state, there is a waking body separate, there is a dream body separate. Due to their presence, there is a difference between Jiva and Brahma. In waking state also, Brahma is separate from the Jiva. In dream state also, Brahma is separate from the Jiva. There is a pratiti. There is an appearance in both waking and dream. Sushuptau tadabhavat bhedo naiva upalabhyata ityataha jiva brahmanor bheda paramarthata naiveti nischiyate. But in the deep sleep state, dreamless sleep state, tadabhavat, there is no pratiti also. There is no pratiti of difference. Therefore, jiva brahmanor bheda paramarthata naiveti nischiyate. There is absence of bheda. There is anupalabdhi of bheda in sushupti, whereas had it been real, had the bheda been real, it should continue to be there in sushupti also. In sushupti there is anupalabdhi. Because of anupalabdhi of bheda, but you recall on waking up that I slept happily, therefore I was there. There is no recollection of bheda. There is recollection of aikya actually. Which is difficult to understand. There is no division at all in the deep sleep state. Where the king is no longer the king. Where the insect is no longer the insect. Where the beggar is not no longer the beggar. Says the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. That kind of shushupti where aikya is clear, should be clear, had it not been for avidya, one would have been mukta. But the avidya continues and thereby during the shushupti avastha, one is unable to understand this aikya. But in waking also, one does not recollect the bheda because bheda isn't there. Thereby, anupalabdhi of bheda is pramana. Shushuptau tadabhavat bhedo naiva upalabhyate ityataha jiva brahmanor bheda paramarthata naiva iti nishchiyate. It is ascertained so iti anupalabdhi pramanam evam eta bheda khandana yuktayaha. These are the ways in which we do bheda khandana and thereby Brahma and pratyak atma, between them there is Veda Badaka Yuktis. Further, Nididhyasana Lakshana. What is Nididhyasana? It is defined Veda Pratyaya, Anatma Pratyaya. Same as Veda Pratyaya. Veda Pratyaya, it is broken here. It should not be broken. There should be a dash at least. Veda Pratyaya Anantarita Brahmakara Pratyaya Pravaha Eva Nididhyasana Puchyate. What is Nididhyasana? Bheda Pratya Anantarita. Brahmakara Pratya Pravaha. Eva Nididhyasana Muchyate. Nididhyasana is nothing but Brahmakara Pratya Pravaha. There is a continuous series of Pratya, series of Vrittis of Brahmakara. Brahmakara Vritti. Pratya Pravaha. There is Brahmakara Vritti. Vritti continues to exist. What is this vritti? It is Brahmakara vritti. This Brahmakara vritti should not be segmented by Bheda Pratya, Bheda vritti. So continuous series of Tailadharavat, there is a Brahmakara vritti without the Bheda Pratiti. That itself is called as Nididhyasana. In yoga, Dharana, then Dhyana. Dharana is trying to focus on a particular object. Here the object in Vedanta is the Mahavakya or something similar which will land in Advaita Tattva. When that becomes a Brahmakara Vritti without any Bheda Vritti, then the Dharana gets converted to Dhyana in Yoga Shastra. Whereas here this will be called as Nididhyasana. Now, in this Nididhyasana, there is only Brahmakara Vritti. The same Nididhyasana Paripaka Vastha Eva Samadhiriti. Dhyana there it is vritti shunya. In yoga shastra they say vritti shunya, yoga chitta vritti nirodha. That is called as sampradnyata samadhi with vritti, asampradnyata samadhi without vritti. Here in Vedanta, savikalpaka samadhi and nirvikalpaka samadhi, two bhedas are done. Savikalpaka samadhi can be compared to the asampradnyata samadhi of the yogis. The difference is that yogis can have anything as an object, shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha, anything, ishvara, prana. And by saying anything, there Patanjali Maharshi says in Yoga Sutras, you can meditate upon anything. He gives some samples and then says, you can meditate upon anything you like. So this also will become included. Mahavakya is included there. Thereby, samadhi one can have on Mahavakya also. But to retain the vritti, brahmakara vritti, and avoid the vritti shunyattvam, Vedantin will hold on to the vritti, thereby savikalpaka samadhi or the asampradnyata samadhi can be said to be equal. Nirvikalpaka samadhi, there is a difference of opinion as to whether there is vritti or not. Trikuti bheda is not there, is accepted. So let's stick to that. That Trikuti bheda drops off in Trikuti is the dhyata, dhyana and the dhyeya. Dhyeya is the Mahavakya, Brahmakara, Vritti. Dhyana is the process going on, Nididhyasanam. Whereas the Dhyata is the Jiva who is following this Nididhyasana. This continues in Savikalpaka Samadhi. In Nirvikalpaka Samadhi, all these three are merged into the Vritti itself, the Dhyeya, Brahmakara. So let's not deal with it more. That is samadhi. What is samadhi? Simple definition of samadhi here is given by sadhu as nididhyasana paripaka avastha. Nididhyasana becomes more and more mature. That's all. What it is, when we reach there, we'll see. Iti. Nididhyasane antarbhavatna samadhi pratak sadhanatvena ganyate. The idea is that samadhi is not a separate sadhana. Samadhi cannot give anything. Now, this is a revealer. I'll just mention it. I'll not delve into it. But this is a revealer. If samadhi is not a pratak sadhana, then if it is same as nididhyasana, then it is a matured nididhyasana. That's the difference. So, nididhyasana can be counted. Samadhi can also be counted. One of them has to be counted. Now, because it is nididhyasana itself which is mature, samadhi is not counted. We'll take it in that manner. Else, samadhi, if there is vritti, if there are vrittis which are objectifiable during the samadhi, then samadhi being on this aikya should have been counted. So I would say that anyatha anupapatya, samadhi can also be considered as vritti shunyatva. But anyway, those who do not agree can keep it in this simple manner, that paripaka avastha, whatever that paripaka avastha is, we'll say that it is Trikuti Rahita Avastha. So that is the Nididhyasana Lakshana. Shravanadi Prayojana Nirupana. What is the Prayojan of each of these? Because we are looking at Anubandha Chatushtaya. In Anubandha Chatushtaya, now we have to analyze this Shravanadi Prayojana also. Shravanadini Yadyapi Na Saksha Jnana Sadhanani Apramanatvat. We saw a little yesterday. Now, antaranga sadhanatvam kasya. Among these eight, starting from Vivekadi, chatushtaya have been shown to be bhairanga, to jnana, to moksha, and the shravanadi are shown to be sakshat jnana sadhana. Then, sakshat antaranga, not sakshat, comparatively sakshat, but better to use antaranga, so not sakshat. Shravanadi ni yadyapi na sakshat jnana sadhanani. Shravanadi are shravana manam nididhyasana, and then finally tattvam shodhanam, tattvam padartha shodhanam. That tattvam padartha shodhana is the fourth which was mentioned earlier. Now, Shravana Manana Nididhyasana are not Sakshat Sadhanas, they are Antaranga Sadhanas. Yadyapina Sakshat Jnana Sadhani. Why do you say Sakshat Jnana Sadhani? They are not everywhere it is considered a Sakshat Sadhana. He says Apramanatvat. Shravana we saw yesterday is not a Pramana. Manana is not a Pramana. It is Sadhana, all right, but it is not a Pramana. Sakshat, it is not a Pramana because we don't see in the listing. Listing only Shabda is mentioned. Shabda is Pramana, therefore Mahavakya alone is Pramana. Shruti is Pramana, Shravana is not Pramana, Manana Bahuduram. Tathapi Tani Jnana Pratibandaki Bhuta Buddhi Dosha Sambhavana Asambhavana Viparita Bhavana Deen Nashayanti. However, what is their Prayojana then? If they are not Pramana, then why should we hold on to it? Tathapi Tani Tani Shravanadini Jnana Pratibandaki Bhuta Buddhi Dosha. What are the Buddhi Dosha? They present obstacles to Jnana. They block the Jnana. So Shravana Manana Nididhyasana are also to remove the obstacles to Jnanotpatti. What are these Doshas? Pratibandaki Bhuta Buddhi Dosha. These are Buddhyantargata Doshas, Antakarana Doshas, which are in the form of asambhavana. It is impossible that I am Brahma. Lot of people, even after many, many years of Shravana, also have this problem, because Shravana, for Shravana also, Vivekadi is not sufficient. If Vivekadi are sufficient, there cannot be asambhavana. Viparita bhavana astu. Viparita bhavana is there for many, which is all right. Viparita bhavana takes a lot of time because it is a very strong impression, set of vasanas collected across janmas, which are difficult to give up when sharira is there. So sharira will keep on dragging person with viparita bhavana, but asambhavana is at the antakkarana level, at the buddhi level. That should go. Asambhavana should go. In fact, one should land on sambhavana. And then asambhavana of dvaita asambhavana. There cannot be bheda. Bheda asambhavana is what should be the phala really. People say that aikya, yes it is aikya, but I think it is impossible in my case at least. They may grant it to others, but in one's own case one holds on to asambhavana. That is a dosha, buddhi dosha. What is it? Samushaya also. If asambhavana gets diluted, the impossibility comes to doubt. Oh, may be possible. Let me inquire into it. So, samshaya. Shravana may lead to taking away asambhavana and one may land into samshaya. What is viparita bhavana? Viparita bhavana is viparyayaha. All the projections of conceit. Basically, tadatme sambandha. That is the end of it is tadatme sambandha. This jagat is where I associate and then take a part, carve out a part of the prapancha and consider it as myself by taking that deha, associating with a particular deha. Dehatma buddhi ityartha. So, nashayanti ityataha sadhanani. They are not sakshat sadhana, but they are nonetheless because they counter all the obstacles to jnanotpatti. Shravanasya upayogaha. So what is the Shravana Upayoga? Vedanta Vakyam Kim Advitiyam Brahma Bodhayati Uta Yat Kinchid Arthantaram Iti Pramana Gata Sandeya Shravanena Nivartyate. Pramana Gata Sandeya Nivartyate Shravanena. Takes away the doubts regarding the Pramana, which is the Shabda, meaning Upanishads. What are the Upanishads really talking about? What is the Tatparya? Vedanta Vakyam, Upanishad Vakyam, Kim Advitiyam Brahma Bodhayati. Do the Upanishads. We should take the entire set. Do all the Upanishads have their Tatparya in Advitiya Brahma? Uta or Yatkinchit Arthantaram or something else? Whether Bheda or Ansha Anshi Bhava or real and unreal both. I mean, this prapancha is of this manner, creation is of this type. what exactly is the Upanishad committed to? Veda or so Dvaita or Vishishta Dvaita or Advaita or Gati somewhere else, Swarga or real bondage going away? What exactly is it revealing? Those doubts are taken away by Shravana. Tru Tatpare Nishya, we have seen yesterday. Mananasya Upayogaha. What is the Upayoga of Manana? Jiva Brahmanur Abheda Satya Uta Bheda Iti. So, Abheda Satya Uta Bheda Satya. Jiva Brahmanur Abheda Satya Uta Jiva Brahmanur Bheda Satya Iti Prameya Gata Sandeha. Such a अनेक प्रकारो अपि मननेन निवार्यते. देर आर वेरियस वेज ऑफ मनना. थ्रू वेरियस वेज ऑफ मनना द डाउट रिगार्डिंग संदेह रिगार्डिंग द प्रमेय. प्रमेय इज व्हाट? द अभेद और भेद. व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज ट्रू सत्य दैट इज taken away, that doubt is taken away by manana. So one takes away the, Shravana takes away the pramana samshaya, whereas the manana takes away prameya samshaya. After Shravana, one should be very sure that Upanishads are teaching Advaita Tattva. That is a phala. Manana, yes, I am that Brahma. This is the manana phala. Prameya. Prameya is me. I am the Prameya Vastu in all the Upanishads. Brahma, which is non-different from me, that is the teaching. It is the Manana Phala. Nididhyasanasya Upayoga. If you have landed, then why do you need Nididhyasana? Nididhyasanasya Upayoga. Dehadi Drishya Prapancha Sarvopi Satyaha Jiva Brahmanur Bhedascha Satyaha Iti Jihi Viparita Bhavana. What is Viparita Bhavana? Considering Viparita is contrary to what is real. There is already a Nishchaya that Upanishad teaches Aikya after Shravana. In Manana, yes, that Aikya is applicable even to me. I have no doubts that I am Brahma. That is Manana Phala. Now what happens is that contrary to that, Viparita to that understanding, there is Puro Vasana working, Viparita Bhavana, which causes, which drags the body-mind-sense complex, drags a person due to the Vasanas which are there, which start manifesting and drag the person out to the level of the body. They bring up, make Brahma person, individual, and based on circumstances, one is dragged down to the level of the body-mind-sense complex. Thereby, Viparita Bhavana is a buddhi, it's a dhi, that Dehadi Drishya Prapanchaha Sarva Api Satyaha. I become an individual. Becoming an individual in my thinking, there is a prapancha outside which is made up of several individuals. So, Dehadi Drishya Prapancha, starting with my body, ending with the other bodies in the Prapancha, is Dehadi Drishya Prapancha, whatever is seen. Drishya Viveka is lost. Just a moment. So, Dehadi Drishya Prapancha, Sarvapi Satyaha, Jiva Brahmano Bheda Cha Satyaha. The world which is seen outside is outside. I am limited. Thereby, there is a creator of this world who is Brahma as per the Shastra. I am different from him. Thereby, all these differences are real. This is the Viparita Bhavana which has always been there before Shravana and Manana. Now this comes up once in a while. Sacha Nididhyasana Nivaryate. That goes away by Nididhyasana. एवं श्रवणादित्रयं ज्ञान प्रतिबंधकी भूत असंभावना विपरीत भावना निवृत्ति द्वारा परंपरया अपरोक्ष ज्ञान साधनम भवति। तो एवं श्रवणादि त्रयम् त्रयम् श्रवणादि त्रयम् इस श्रवण मनन निधिध्यासन श्रवणादि त्रयम् ज्ञान प्रतिबंधकी भूत असंभावना विपरीत भावना। We have seen this earlier also. ज्ञान प्रतिबंधकी भूत दोज विच आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ऑब्स्टैकल्स टू ज्ञान आफ्टर द ज्ञानोत्पत्ति। अर्लियर वी सॉ फॉर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति, नाउ आफ्टर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति ऑल्सो देर आर प्रतिबंधकास विच हैव बीन टेकन अवे सम बाय श्रवण एंड मनना, देयरफॉर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति वॉज पॉसिबल। नाउ इवन आफ्टर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति दैट ज्ञान इज नॉट स्थिर, इट हैज कम अबाउट बट देन इट डज नॉट रिमेन बिकॉज ऑफ दिस विपरीत भावना, देयर बाय दीज हैव टू बी टेकन अवे। Earlier it was asambhavana, and this asambhavana may come up, satya, when you have thinking, no, it is satya, then asambhavana may crop up again, viparita bhavana may continue, thereby, shravanadi trayam, the all three put together, nivritti dvara, paramparaya, aparoksha jnana sadhanam bhavati, paramparaya, natu sakshat. Therefore, the entire triad of shravana mana nididhyasana, just take away the obstacles to jnanotpatti by taking away asambhavana and viparita bhavana. That Shruti talks about aikya, that kind of asambhavana is pramana gata sandeha. Asambhavana that I cannot be that is taken away by manana, which is prameya gata sandeha asambhavana. Viparita bhavana is taken away by nididhyasana. Yes, it is true, but I can't hold on to it. There is no nitaram sthiti. Nishta is lacking. All those are taken away by the triad. Therefore, paramparaya aparoksha jnana sadhanam bhavati. So, natu sakshat. So far, what has been said is that every sadhana is taking away some kind of an obstacle. Earlier, Chitta Shuddhi, Vivekadi Chatushtaya, now Shravanadi Traya is taking away the obstacles to Jnanotpatti, to Nishtha in Jnana. What about Jnanotpatti itself? How do you get Jnanotpatti? Natu Sakshat. These are not Sakshat Sadhana. Then what is the Sakshat Sadhana? Aparoksha Jnana Sakshat Sadhanam. Jnanasya Sakshat Sadhanam to Shrotrendriya Sambaddha Vedanta Vakyam Eva. This is very important, lost on many. I am doing Shravanam punah punah kuryat. There is a statement, Shravanam punah punah kuryat. But Shravana, when Shravana is taking place, listen to anything and everything. That is not Shravana leading to Phala. Phala is only by Sakshat sadhana. Sakshat sadhana for jnana is Shrotrendriya sambaddha Vedanta vakyam eva. Vedanta vakya itself leads to moksha. How so? Neti neti. There also neti neti. It reveals, and by revealing aikya, it takes away the misunderstanding caused by ajnana. Adhyasa caused by ajnana. The ajnana is taken away. Thereby, ajnana karya adhyasa is taken away. Thereby, vikshepa goes away. When the avarana is taken away, ajnana is countered by the Vedanta vakya, which is jnana. Which leads to jnana, that jnana being stronger than ajnana, which is jnana virodhi. Jnana virodhi ajnanam. Ajnana nunge there in ajnanam, na jnanam ajnanam, that nunge there is virodarthe nunge. It is opposing the aikya jnana. Yat kinchit bhava padartha. Ajnanam. It is not abhava rupa ajnana. Abhava cannot give rise to anything. Abhava cannot lead to bondage. The ajnana that leads to bondage has to be bhava rupa. Yat kinchit bhava rupa. If it is satya, it will never go away. If it is शून्य असत, देन बॉन्डेज वुड नेवर बी देर. सो यत्किंचित भाव रूप पदार्थ वी शुड एक्सेप्ट पदार्थ विच इज अज्ञानम, दैट अज्ञान इज अपोज टू ज्ञान, ऐक्य ज्ञान. ऐक्य ज्ञान बिकम स्ट्रॉन्गर बाय द साक्षात साधन ऑफ वेदांत वाक्य श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय संबद्ध वेदांत वाक्यम. वेदांत वाक्य विच इज हर्ड वाया श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय, दैट वेदांत वाक्य. सी श्रवण इज वॉट, श्रवण इज श्रु धातु प्लस ल्युट, भावे ल्युट. दैट श्रवणम इज हियरिंग. What you are hearing, that is Mahavakya. Some may get confused that that is Shravana. No, Shrotrendi Sambandha Vedanta Vakya I am listening to, that is Shravana. That is not Shravana. Shravana is the process of hearing. Bhave Vitpatti, Lyud. Here we have Shrotrendriya Sambandha Vedanta Vakyam. Vedanta Vakya itself causes Jnanotpatti. It should be connected to the Shrotrendriya. There is a lot of technicality here as to why Shrotrendriya, why cannot I look at it and read? You can read, but it is not Shrotrendriya Sambandha. A lot of Indriyas are at play. When you are reading, your eyes are open. There is a lot of noise there. Anyway, we'll not delve into it much right now. Shrotrendriya Sambandha, let's understand that Vedanta Vakyam, Sakshat Sadhanam Jnanasya. Jnana arises only due to Vedanta Vakya, nothing else is Pramana. Shrotrendriya Sambandha Vedanta Vakyam Eva Jnanasya Sakshat Sadhanam. Tachya Dviprakaram. Now that is of two types. Paroksha, Aparoksha, both. Avantara Vakyam, Mahavakyam Cheti. Avantara Vakyam. Other than Mahavakyas are Avantara Vakyam. Mahavakyas are those which teach Aikya between the व्यष्टि एंड समष्टि. अवांतर वाक्य आर एनीथिंग अदर देन दोस. सो अवांतर वाक्य महावाक्यम च इति वेदांत वाक्यम द्विप्रकारम. जीवात्म परमात्म स्वरूप प्रतिपादक वाक्यम अवांतर वाक्यम. हु इज दिस जीवा, हु इज दिस परमात्मा, दीज काइंड ऑफ स्टेटमेंट्स, दीज काइंड ऑफ रिवीलिंग स्टेटमेंट्स. हु इज जीवा, लॉट ऑफ डिस्कशन इज देयर ऑन जीवोत्पत्ति. तस्माद् वा एतस्माद् आत्मना आकाश संभूत आकाशाद् वायु एंड सो ऑन. एंटायर सीक्वेंस ऑफ क्रिएशन इज ऑल्सो देयर विद परमात्मा जगत कारण. फाइनली औषधीभ्यो अन्नम अन्नात् पुरुषः. सो अन्नात् पुरुषः इज जीवोत्पत्ति इज द मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग देयर, बट इट टीचेस अन्नात् पुरुषः कः सः पुरुषः और अनेन आत्मना अनुप्रविश्य अथवा तत् सृष्ट्वा तदेव अनुप्राविशत. Having created that Purusha, he entered. All this is, oh, entered, then there is a Jiva, there is a Paramatma. All these are revealed in the Shruti. So, Jivatma, Paramatma, Swarupa, Pratipadaka Vakyam, Avantara Vakyam. Tadaikya Pratipadaka Vakyam, Mahavakyam, iti cha uchyate. What is Mahavakya? Those which teach Aikya between this Jiva and Paramatma. There is a general discussion. And there is a specific discussion. In the specific discussion, you have, oh, who is this Jiva? Samsari Jiva. Then there is Paramatma. Who is that Paramatma? Jagat Karana. He is the creator. Srishti, Siti, Laya Karanam, Tat Jalana. So in Chandogya, I think Tritiya, Panchamodhyaya, Tat Jalana. Tasmad Jayate. Tasmad परमात्मनः जायते प्रपंच. सो इज तज्ज देन तल्ल तस्मिन् लीयते तस्मिन्नेव परब्रह्मणि परमात्मनि लीयते प्रपंच. देयरफॉर तल्ल तज्ज तज्जलान अन तस्मिन् अनति तेन तेन अनति. सो इज सस्टेन्ड बाय हिम, सस्टेन्ड बाय द सेम परमात्मा. Thereby, he is Srishti Sthiti Laya Karana Tajjalana. Samasa is shortened further by Shruti by calling Brahma Tajjalana. ऑल दीज आर परमात्मा डिस्कशंस. प्रतिपादक वाक्यम अवांतर वाक्यम एंड महावाक्यम विल शो ऐक्य बिटवीन जीव एंड परमात्मा. अवांतर वाक्य न परोक्षम एव ज्ञानं जायते. थ्रू अवांतर वाक्य व्हाट हैपेंस? ओनली परोक्ष ज्ञान कैन टेक प्लेस. अवांतर वाक्य न परोक्षम एव ज्ञानं जायते. इट इज नॉट इमीडिएट. इमीडिएट नॉलेज इज बॉर्न आउट ऑफ अवांतर वाक्य. ओ जीवा इज देर, देर इज अ परमेश्वर. तो ब्रह्म अस्ति इति ज्ञानम महावाक्येन तु अपरोक्षमेव. महावाक्य लीड्स टू अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. अपरोक्ष इज इमीडिएट. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू? अस्ति ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानम परोक्षम. यस देर इज ब्रह्म. अस्ति अस्तित्ववादी. अस्ति ब्रह्म. ऑल द वैदिकास से ब्रह्म अस्ति. शून्यवादी जैनास बुद्धिस्ट बेसिकली नीड नॉट बी शून्यवादी. बौद्ध मत एंड जैन मत देर दे डोंट हैव कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ब्रह्म अस्ति बिकॉज अवैदिक. ब्रह्म अस्ति इति ज्ञानम परोक्षम. यस देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड ब्रह्म. सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म. अवांतर वाक्य दैट विल लीड टू परोक्ष ज्ञान. ओ यस देर इज ब्रह्म. सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म एग्जिस्ट. सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म. देर इज some entity like that. Aham eva brahma iti jnanam aparoksham. I am that brahma. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma aham asmi. Satchidananda brahma aham asmi iti jnanam aparoksham. That is immediate knowledge. Tameva brahma si iti guru pudishta mahavakya shravananantaram shrotu shishyasya pushkala sadhana sampannasya. पुष्कल साधन संपन्नस्य शिष्यस्य. हु इज अ श्रोता? हु इज लिसनिंग टू द गुरु उपदेश? व्हाट इज दैट गुरु उपदेश? महावाक्य. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ महावाक्य? त्वमेव ब्रह्मासि तत्त्वमसि. यू आर दैट ब्रह्म. द गुरु इज टीचिंग यू आर दैट ब्रह्म एंड देर इज अ श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय संबंध महावाक्य. नाउ त्वमेव ब्रह्मासि. दिस इज द महावाक्य विच इज श्रोतुः श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय संबद्ध महावाक्य. हु इज दिट श्रोता? श्रोता इज अ शिष्य हु हैज श्रद्धा इन द गुरु. गुरु हु इज इन द संप्रदाय टीचिंग द श्रुति. ही नोज दैट ही इज टीचिंग द श्रुति एंड इन हिज उपदेश ही हैज श्रुति एंड गुरु उपदेश ही हैज श्रद्धा इन दैट काइंड ऑफ अ शिष्य. बट हु इज ऑल्सो पुष्कल साधन संपन्न. ही शुड बी विवेकादि साधन चतुष्टय संपन्न. तस्य शिष्यस्य अहम् ब्रह्मास्मि इति अपरोक्षम् एव ज्ञानं जायते. व्हेन ही सेज त्वमेव ब्रह्मासि देन ही अंडरस्टैंड्स एज अहम् ब्रह्मास्मि इति अपरोक्षम् एव ज्ञानं जायते. दैट इज इमीडिएट. दैट इज ज्ञान रियली. एनीथिंग एल्स इज नॉट रियली अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. दैट ज्ञान विल नॉट लीड टू मुक्ति. ओनली दिस अहम ब्रह्मास्मि इति अपरोक्षम एव ज्ञानम विल लीड टू मुक्ति. श्रोत्रेण असंबद्धम वाक्यम नैव ज्ञानम जनयेत. ई वाक्य विच इज नॉट कनेक्टेड टू श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय विल नॉट लीड टू ज्ञानोत्पत्ति. डज नॉट लीड टू ज्ञानोत्पत्ति. वाई? वाई नॉट? Why should it be? Why should it be so? I get all sorts of knowledges elsewhere. Why should I not get this knowledge also? However, I want. Shabda Pramana works in this manner. It is not Drishya Pramana. It is Shabda Pramana. Shabda Pramana has its own way of working. It has nothing else in between. There is no block there. There is no scattering there. Shrotrendriya, the way it works is a little different. Shabda Pramana works only in this manner. You cannot say that I'll read. If you read, it is not Shabda. Shabda is, for Shabda, Pramana is Shrotrendriya. So when you say Shabda Pramana, we have all studied that Shabda is a Pramana. When you say Shabda is a Pramana, you cannot say I'll read the Shabda. If you read the Shabda, then your Shrotrendriya is not being used and you are not using the Shabda as Pramana. Something else is Pramana. There your eyes are working. Eyes are working, that time what you get is not Aparoksha Jnana. It does not lead to Jnana Utpatti. It is not Shabda Pramana at all. Shabda Pramana will work only through Shrotrendriya. Shrotrena Asambaddham Vakyam Naiva Jnanam Janayet. अतहा श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय संबद्ध महावाक्यम एव अपरोक्ष ज्ञान हेतु. सो व्हाट इज साक्षात साधना फॉर ज्ञान अपरोक्ष ज्ञान एस्पेशली अपरोक्ष ज्ञान ओनली श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय संबद्ध महावाक्यम. महावाक्य इज द कॉज फॉर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति. एनीवन एल्स सेज दैट नो माय गुरु गॉट इट विदाउट वेदांता, वन इनकरेक्ट, सेकेंड ही डज नॉट नो, third, the guru may not recall, but in Purva Janma, there has been Mahavakya Upadesha, which has worked except for the Prarabdha Lesha, which may have taken away the obstacles right now. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana, the way they take away obstacles. Vivekadi Sadhana Chaturthya Sampatti or others also take away obstacles. When they take away obstacles, some prarabdha lesha is there, that goes away. It appears as though out of nothing, one has become mukta. Siddhi lacking. Siddhi lacking, one may not know as to how a person got mukti, but it is always due to Shrotrendriya Sambaddha Mahavakya, now or earlier. महावाक्येन सर्वेषां ज्ञानं अपरोक्षम एव जायते न तु परोक्षम इति नियमः. एंड व्हाट इज दी नियम हियर, व्हाट इज दी रूल? महावाक्येन सर्वेषां ज्ञानं अपरोक्षम एव जायते. यू कैन नॉट से दैट आई हैव हर्ड दी महावाक्य बट आई हैव नॉट नो अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. दैट इज ओनली पॉसिबल इफ ज्ञान इटसेल्फ इज नॉट बॉर्न. इफ ज्ञान इज बॉर्न देन इट हैज टू बी अपरोक्ष, इट कैन नॉट बी परोक्ष. Natu paroksham iti niyamah. This is the niyama. Now, for this there are objections. We look it in the next part. Mahavakyam aparoksha jnana hetu iti atra akshepa samadhanani. There is a question here. We look at that. Pramana is what? Upanishad vakyani shabda pramana. Shabda pramana is pramana. Nothing other than shabda is pramana in this case. In every other case, in Laukika, all other pramanas there, Laukika Shabda is also there, but in Alaukika, Alaukika Vishaye, Veda Shabda Eva Pramanam. Veda Shabda Eva Pramanam means only here in our case, Upanishad Vakyani Shabda Pramanam. Prameya is what? Mokshadi Jnaya Vishaya. The Mokshadi Jnaya Vishaya, what is this? It is Aikya, that is Prameya, those Vakyas. Talking about Atma and Brahma, they are Prameya. So this is today's Patha. We'll look at more in the Akshep and Samadhana in the next Patha. Sukhan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Nama Rupayo Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Yattu Nirmalam Aparam Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Hannamattonyat Iti Menishitamatihi. Any questions? Okay, there is, see, anything other than Mahavakya, auxiliary or whatever, any Vakya which is not teaching Aikya is Avantara Vakya. But here specifically it is defined as to what is the nature of the Jiva, what is the nature of the Paramatma. These are Avantara Vakya. There are other Vakyas also. For example, there may be a Vakya which is talking about something which is completely unrelated to Jiva and Paramatma also in Shruti. So people say that, you know, some scientific things have been discussed. They are all not scientific at all. These are, you know, they are just restatements. Those restatements are not Pramana for anything. They will not lead to any kind of knowledge. So they are not considered as Avantara Vakyas also. Even if you consider in this book, they are not considered as Avantara Vakya. So we can say that, is it talking about Jiva? Yes. Is it talking about Jiva as Brahma? No, then it is Avantara Vakya. Is it talking about Brahma? Yes. Is it talking about Brahma as Jiva? No, then Avantara Vakya. If it is talking about Aikya, it is Mahavakya. That's all.
Praveen ji.
Yes.
Namaste.
Namaskara.
Yes. Now, Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma, is it an Avantra Vakya or a Mahavakya, Guruji?
Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma. It depends on how it is understood. See, when it is said Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma, to make it a sentence, see, Ekatinga Vakyam, this is why Vyakrana is important. Ekatinga Vakyam, what is the Vakyam here? Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma. Tingantam padam putrasti. Where is the verb here? What is the verb you will supply?
Asti.
Asti. Asti iti jnanam asti. Brahma asti. Sarvam kalvidam brahma asti iti paroksham jnanam janayati.
Paroksham jnanam janayati.
Because it is asti. You have nothing to do with asti. Asti is, where is asti used? Asti is prathama purusha ekavachana. It is not the speaker, it is not the listener, it is someone other than you and me. Mahavakya, all right, but it is not aparoksha jnana, it is not leading to aparoksha jnana.
Understood, because there is a differentiation between the speaker and the sarvam.
Yes, the moksha is for the person who is doing shravana, who is doing manana, who is doing nididhyasana. Now, if this Mahavakya, which is showing aikya, is generated, it is Mahavakya, all right. It is Mahavakya. Your question is right. The answer is yes, it is a Mahavakya. But it is not a Mahavakya which will generate aparoksha jnana. It will generate only paroksha jnana. So, Brahma asti. Brahma asti will not lead to aparoksha jnana. Brahma asmi, that's why what you supply there, if that also can be generating aparoksha jnana, if one has understood, and whenever the word Brahma comes in, he substitutes that with aham. Sarvam khalvidam brahmatma asmi. If one understands in this manner, then that mahavakya will generate aparoksha jnana.
Aparoksha. Understood, Guruji. Understood.
Hariyom.
Yes.
Yeah, but in the footnote...
Can those have questions, can they mute themselves, please?
Hari Om.
Yeah.
In the footnote, there is difference between Sakshatkara and Nididhyasana. Can you just explain that?
Sorry? Sakshatkarana and Nididhyasana, you didn't get the difference.
No, in the footnote, it has been given. Ayameva Vedaha Sakshatkara Nididhyasana Yoho.
Where?
After Anupalabdhi Pramana. 1, 2, 3, 4. After that first one.
Ayameva Bheda Sakshatkara Nididhyasana Yoho Bheda. So Ayameva Bheda Sakshatkara Nididhyasana. So Ayameva, what is this? Namri Bhuta Vruksha Shakha Vad Vinayeva Swaprayatnam Aham Brahmasmiti Vedanta Janya Anatma Kara Vritti Rupa Antaraya Rahita Brahmakara Vritti Sakshatkara Uchyate. What is Brahma Sakshatkara? Brahmakara Vritti. Brahmakara Vritti, which is Anatmakara Vritti Rupa Antaraya Rahita, which is not interleaved by Anatmakara Vritti. That is called as Sakshatkara. Now, what is your question? What is the difference between Nididhyasana and Sakshatkara?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, so Nididhyasana, Swayam Eva Namri Bhuta Vruksha Shakha Vad Vina Eva Swapretam Aham Brahmasmiti Vedanta Janya Anatmakara Vritti Rupa Raya Rahita Brahmakara Vritti Sakshatkara Nididhyasana Tu Swapretnad Swapretnad. Here what is it? Swapretnam Swayam Eva Vina Eva Swapretnam Vina Swapretnam. Here what? Nididhyasana Tu Swapretnad.
Oh, only by effort.
Yeah, so there is a difference that in Nididhyasana, effort is needed. Here, in Sakshatkara, there is no effort involved.
Swayam Eva, there.
Swayam Eva. So yeah, that is the difference. That's why Nididhyasana, there is a lot of effort to take away the Viparita Bhavana. Okay?
Thank you.
Anything else? Anyone else?
We have class tomorrow, no?
Hari Om.
Yeah.
That is all other this Avantara Vakya, everything except that Mahavakyas, they will give us Dvaita, is it? Dvaita knowledge.
Not necessarily Dvaita, what they give is irrelevant. What will they give is irrelevant. Because Avantara Vakya, if something is, depends on the person who is understanding, the person who is teaching also. What these Vakyas will give is, cannot be said as, we cannot make a blanket statement as to what will the Avantara Vakyas give. Avantara Vakyas are so many, depends on what they are teaching, they'll give. Whatever is the understanding, you'll get. See, if there's a teaching that, you know, like the sparks came up from the fire, from Paramatma, Jivas have come, what will they give? Depends on the understanding as to the explanation also what follows.
Oh. Guruji, this is Venkatesh. Can I take a minute?
Sorry?
Venkatesh here, can I take a minute, Guruji?
Yeah. Tell me.
Yeah. So can we say that Nityasana's pala will be only Paroksha Jnana, whereas Atma Sakshatkara would lead to Aparoksha Jnana, or Aparoksha Jnana is Atma Sakshatkara and Paroksha Jnana is the pala of...
No, you can't make that division because see, Nididhyasana is not Sakshat Sadhana at all. It is going to take away obstacles. It is not giving anything else. So what it will lead to, you cannot say that it will lead to Paroksha or Aparoksha Jnana. Paroksha Aparoksha Jnana is dependent on the Vakya, Mahavakya. Whether Asti or Asmi. So Nididhyasana has no connection there. Nididhyasana is just taking away obstacles to Nishtha.
Understood. So even the jnana itself happens only on tatvam pada vichara or the...
Not even vichara, jnana here. See, this is why I'm saying that this text is very much focused on accuracy. It is saying that shravana. Elsewhere we have always retained that shravana manana nididhyasana lead to jnana. Here it has said that Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana do not lead to Jnana on their own. Mahavakya is a Sakshat Sadhana. When that is said, we cannot say Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana lead to Paroksha or Aparoksha. They have no connection at all. They are removing the obstacles. In fact, in Mandukya, it is said that this Jnanotpatti, which takes place, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says there that Jnanotpatti which takes place through Mahavakya also, Mahavakya is not teaching Aikya in the manner that you think that it is teaching Aikya. The way it is teaching Aikya is not that it is going to generate a Jnana that you are one with Ishvara. What it does it takes that also, Mahavakya also, Sakshat Sadhana all right. But it also takes away by neti prakriya.
Okay.
Finally, it should land the person, Brahmakara Vritti. What it does is that I am Brahma means what? Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi is equal to I am nothing else but Brahma. When I say I am nothing else, that is the real phala, neti. That is the way it works. It is not by aikya as, okay, I was not one, now I am one. No. It is that I was never different. I was never different because I was never sambandha with the sharira.
Yes.
So it all works with neti. Otherwise, there is an issue which Bhagavan Bhashyakara handles in Mandukya Upanishad. So it will take away the carpet that you are standing on. This work is also doing the same thing. Sravana Mana Nidhyasana, I am doing that, but are you listening to the Mahavakya, which is Sakshat Sadhana? Are we there yet?
Understood.
Anything else, anyone else? Ramaji, I hope I have answered your question as well.
Yes. Yes.
Surbhi Amma, did you have any question?
No. We have classes tomorrow, no?
Sorry?
We have classes tomorrow, Guru Purnima.
Sunday, I'll have a class. Early morning, I'll have a class. Those who can join may join. Sure. Those who cannot can use the recording if they want. Okay.
Thank you.
I prefer to have a class on Guru Purnima.
Yes.
It's respect to the Sampradaya.
Yes.
Thank
you very much.
Okay, namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste.